Hello, welcome to the next video in our Path of Exile Hardcore Solo Self-Found League Start Guide. So what we're going to be doing is going through Act 3, and we already went through like an organized inventory from last time. So we're pretty much going to do the same thing. We got like a 1, 2, 3, 4 loot tabs here, except we have a couple items that we didn't quite want to get rid of yet. And we have, we're looking at our tab. Like, the only tab that doesn't look good is this level 1 tab. Because we never farmed anything. We never tried to farm anything. We just went through the game, just picked up some leveling equipment. It's like our level 10 tab looks a lot better, because we got a bunch of light brigandines here. Then our level 20 tab, we were able to fill this out with the copper plates like we planned. So I guess the only thing that we don't have is just like a Ranger armor with like three blue sockets links. So we got this chest piece here, so a three socket link ring bow coat. Would be better than like any silken vest, I think. As well as we start working on this. Although, we're going to be getting better armors than this, because these armors here, they require level 17, so we're going to be using these ones. Then these ones require level 21, so it's just like a 4 level difference, right? So what we're going to be doing is keep it going through. Then we're probably going to find the level 28 armors, because if we look at our character, the whole reason to do this is our character is level 28 right now. The only gear that we have access to is level 21 gear, right? And we're at level 28. If we had level 28 gear, we could equip it right now, and our character would be a lot stronger than he is. And same with this thing, right? This level 17 gear. Pretty much, we maybe be level 17 after we get to the crossroads here. Once you're 17, we could just equip the full set of level 17 armor before we're even supposed to be getting it. Same with Act 1 here, right? As soon as we get to the prison, then we can equip our level 8 armor before we're supposed to be able to get it. And I think it's probably more effective later, right? Because like in the earlier levels, maybe it doesn't matter too much. Maybe you can find everything. But then later, you're searching for the socket links. So before we go, we're going to be upgrading our boots here. We've been using these level 1 boots for so long just because they have movement speed. And we're gonna upgrade to these because they have a lot of armor and a lot of evasion, and they have a lot of max life. Plus, they have the 8% increased rarity of items found. So we'll change our boots. They got like a vitality. Then we got Ray Zombie. Then we got Arc, and that should work. These are level 1 boots. So we have some really good level 1 boots for the Templar over here, right? It's a level 1 requirement, it has 10% movement speed. So we can use our own boots. Then we weren't going to use that. Yeah, there wasn't anything else, because we were thinking of using these gloves to get the blue link sockets, but it doesn't matter, because this is a corrupt gauntlet, and it's rare anyways. And it gives life plus a life regen, 10% rarity. And we get a life per enemy kill. And it has the two blue sockets here. So what we're going to do is just go through Act 3 here. So it shouldn't take too long. It shouldn't be difficult or anything. So we have like all of our skills set up. We got all of our skill gems and everything. We got pretty good armor. I guess we're gonna be getting armor upgrades because here we're gonna start seeing like four socket items. As soon as we get to four socket linked items, we're gonna be able to upgrade them. Which is another thing. If we had these four socket linked items right now, our character would be a lot stronger. But because we have to go get these four socket linked items, our character is not really at his full potential at the moment. Whereas he's like a two socket link to that three socket link. So once it gets up to four socket link. Oh, copper tower shield. We got a upgrade here. So we're probably gonna switch that right away if we don't need the sockets. But it looked like it already had the colors that we needed. Because if you look here, copper tower shield, 152 armor plus 40 life. Oh, the life is maxed. So we're probably going to put this on if we got another blue socket. That's going to increase our defense tremendously, right? We're at 69% damage reduction already. And it brings it all the way up to 76. So we probably do that. We just got a huge shield upgrade, right? This copper tower shield. Which, if we have this copper tower shield at the end of, what, Act 2? We can use this copper tower shield against the boss, right? So it would have made that a lot easier. So guess we'll keep going through. We'll get this lockbox thing here. We'll get it, then teleport away, and then go up and cast Ice Nova. Yeah, then I guess we'll just keep going. So we can't access this gate until we complete the other app of the quest here. It's not gonna be this way. It's probably like all the way over here. What's that three thing item? Oh, it's just the staff. Where is it? How do we go the wrong way there? Why is there so many dead ends on this map? I wonder if we should get the clarity gem again. I was thinking about it, because we have like a mana problem like all the time. It's like always running out of mana, but I guess we don't have the clarity gem. Yeah, I guess we'll just go bank quick. Just go to the bank and then sell everything. If this server is an upgrade, we'll probably use it. So it does have the lightning res. Do we need the cold res? So I guess that's all right. Oh, it's like half the armor, never mind. Let's keep that one. I still don't need these, but I need to sell these later eventually. Oh, we got a new flask upgrade, actually. So I guess we got a new flask, the giant life flask. It just depends if an ID has 66% reduced amount recovered, so we can't use it for anything. So let's keep going through here. And all we have to do is complete the trial down here and then feel like a piety. So I guess there's like two things we have to do here. So they've had, yeah, a trial over here. Let's go complete this quick. So it's the fire one, so the ground is gonna be on fire. So all we have to do is just make sure we don't sit out of the ground for too long. This lever, if you have to hit like another lever here, they have to go through this door. They can stay here and then wait, right? You don't have to rush or anything, you can wait on these things. Just had to beat him. Then we completed the trial over here. To be tempered by the flames of the past. So now we just have to do the secondary quest. Three socket link chest piece with four different sockets. Oh, here's the quest we need to do. There's also a crafting recipe here. So we'll click this. Defense is rank one. As long as our landing grass is high enough, we should be alright. Alright. So then, we have to come here. Collect this item. Go back to town. I still don't need this, two-hand weapon. Go back to now, complete the quest, then go down the sewer. So that was pretty quick. We did that in less than like 10 minutes here. I wonder if that rigs any good. Oh, it doesn't have any resistances. Yeah, we need them at the moment. So we can't take that. Then we talk to you. Then we get these keys. Do we talk to you? Goodbye. No, we don't. Talk to a member. Okay, so we get a skeleton reward here. Yeah, flammability, conductivity. So I think we're supposed to get like a conductivity or like a elemental weakness. Then we cast this and then they get a weaker arc, raise up, seven skeletons, tempest shield, herald of thunder, frost blink. We can't really lose anything. That's usually what always happens. Usually you get this skill gem. They have nowhere to put it. It is a really good skill gem, though. Elemental weaknesses. Because it reduces their resistances by 60%. So you have to get another blue socket to use it. I guess we'll just put it here for now. So what we're gonna do is, we just have to go right out the tower here. So we have the keys. And if we get some more blue socks later, then we can start using that elemental weakness ability. That'll help our holy flame totem too. Or we get the conductivity, which lowers their lightning resistance, increases the chance to shock, but it doesn't help out your totem as much. Here's the sewers right here. What if you actually want to pick up this boot knife through socket lake? Because if I use that, blue blue green's pretty good. I got a new health flask. So we'll take that. There'll always be like a one before the waypoint, and then the other two are always after the waypoint, I believe. Should go here, and then here's the crafting recipe, so then the waypoint should be here soon. And then we'll just go bake quick. Another thing is just gonna refill these quicksilver flasks, or quicksilver flasks are empty. So refill our quicksilver flasks here. And I guess we can see if this wand was anything. Do we just pick up like a... Yeah, I guess it didn't really do anything, so the wand was really that good. What about this quartz wand? Yeah, that wasn't that good either. I think we can talk to him and then turn this in, maybe? Yeah, that'll give us an extra inventory space. So you come here, turn that one in, go back to the sewers over here. I'll just go click the other two items here, then we get at the inventory again. Oh, four sock like padded vest and then the diamond ring rare. Pad jacket. So that's pretty good. So now our characters, when they're like act two, they can wear this four socket like the padded jacket. So that's a good thing, right? Four socket like they're as early as you get them. Cloud staff's not four socket like, that's why it's not glowing. Now we have to search for the second boss because we see that the exit was up there, so we have to go back and search for it. Oh, it's just right over here. There we go, now we just have to find the exit of the place over here. Maybe we'll check this place, right? There could be, there was a leaping catacomb here. So I usually check these side things. Because you can't find some extra loot up here. So now we just have to work our way to the exit. We have the other two pieces here. Then we could unlock a new hideout here, the Undercity Hideout. So what we do here is we come and we clear out this side area. Then we get a new hideout if we want it. So it's just like the layout of it. So I think you have to go through like unlock all of them. So that's something to do. So like we killed everything here, so we would have unlocked this hideout, and then she would have been here to greet you. She would have been like, you unlocked a new hideout, and then we can change it to this one if we want. And then we go to the sewers here, and then we just go and complete the rest of the quest over here. Oh yeah, we don't get to the waypoint quite yet. So what we have to do is go through here. There could be like a side quest objective. It could be his first area, or it could be like way the other area. It's so rad. Oh, you just have to go around, search to find the greed. Oh, the quest arc is right here. That's what you find it, then we go to the next area. Maybe just take these three socket broadscale gauntlets. It's because it'd be good for a ranger. Four stock like the sledgehammer. The whole bunch of rare items? Oh, we can't even carry it all. So we just do this, and then we go back home, and then just bake all this. Oh, we can go turn in the quest here too. So we go turn these in, complete this quest. Oh, we need to get some inventory space. So we get a skill point for doing that. All right, we go here. Maybe we could use the bell. Oh, it doesn't have any resistance. Should probably throw these in here. I wonder if that rig's any good. No resistances. So we can't use it. So what we'll do is just go back here. Then we'll just keep going. And I know we have like three skill points, but it doesn't really matter at this point. I hope you spent them pretty soon here. Cause like we need like 5 points. I think we need 5 points before it's worth doing anything with them. So now we have to come here and beat on these guys. Oh, we need the tempest shield on. Yeah, might as well just go through here, complete this side quest area, the catacombs. I think it's always right near this waypoint here. I think all we have to do is just like a trial out here, that's it. I found some plated greaves. Alright, so I guess it was that way, but there's a whole bunch of loot that way, which is good. So did they change the recipe? Because we're trying to sell something. It's supposed to be if you have a 20% quality, I was supposed to sell for the scrap piece, but it didn't. We need like two of them to make it equal 40% for some reason. I got them, we dropped like so many things. Rare play greens and rare gold amulet. So you have to go home and sell some things, or at least throw them in the bank. And maybe we've had some upgrades. So we just have this copper tower shield, and there was a rare copper tower shield there. Three stock of lake knives, these plated greaves. Oh, they're much better than our thing if you don't need the red socket, which you don't. So I think we'll get that. That'll increase our armor by quite a bit. So this has dex, we can use it. Oh, so we got a 20% magic fire plus 17% lightning res, plus we got enough dex to use our stuff here. So our lightning res is a bit too high. So we figured out how to get like cold and lightning res or something. I guess we figure it out here later, right? Yeah, it is pretty high. It's like 74, 75, 66%. Resistance is doing all right. They've got a D magic fight amulet. So go through the catacombs. Go pick up these rare items we get. It has copper tower shield. If you need the blue item, the ringmail coat. I guess it's just because it's only three socks. They're not linked. It'd be so much better. Frostblake. Maybe we don't need summon skeletons or something. They put this on, that'd be a huge shield upgrade. Then we get some cold res. So we're gonna do is complete the trial, because I think that's like the only thing there is to do. You just have to watch out for these blades, they can do so much damage to you. That says it kill you so quick. So what we do, I think, is go around here and hit this lever. And then we just keep going. Then you gotta craft the recipe here. We get the elemental damage with attacks, rank 1, and then another boot knife, I guess. 2-stone ring, giant life flask. Oh, we need this. So we get another life flask upgrade here. They have to watch out for these blades. And then we completed it. Alright, so we just have one trial left to complete here. And then we could return to town. We're not done that. What if these boots be an upgrade if they have like a movement speed? Oh, they have 10% movement speed. Add a lot of evasion plus life, plus a rarity, plus lightning res. So we put these on. We get a lot more sockets for doing that. And I think we can switch out that rig now, right? We got like a 94% lightning resistance. So we need to figure out how to get a fire resistance. Fire lightning res. Yes, now we got 66%. And everything else is 75%. So I guess that's alright. We're getting pretty close to max resistances here. So with skeletons, we don't have a roof for that at the moment. So what we're going to do is return to the marketplace. We have to work our way to the docks over here. Oh, it's probably over here, I guess. Oh, did our vitality are on. Oh, four sock like deerskin boots. That'd be good for a razor. Here's the exit. Another jewel box. They're already here at the battlefield. I think that was so quick, it's just been like 30 minutes. So it'll probably take us like 40 minutes to do the first part, and then 40 minutes to do the second part. Seems to be what it's like. So we'll go up here and get the waypoint. Which item was that? Maybe we'll actually get the perfect defense? You get the waypoint. There's a quest I have to get. Then we'll just head north here if we don't need to go bake anything. Oh, we got a unique item. We got a unique iron mask. That's like the first unique item we got so far. So go pick this up. We got a unique mask. So we actually got a unique item here. Then we head to the docks. There's that inventory space. And then we'll complete everything over here. And then go work on the next area. Oh, those poison things. We certified full rig bales now. Level 28, right? This is level 28 gear. So if we can use this level 28 gear at like the beginning of the act, or before we leave the last act, it would have helped out so much. So we get the waypoint, and we talk to Fair Grace. There's something else we have to do here. So might as well go home. And if we didn't need the resistances, maybe this would be a upgrade here, right? Oh yeah, I guess it's not. I see, these things aren't filled up too much. Wonder if you should ID the unique item. We probably won't use it, right? Card level 17, plus strength, plus lightning rest, spells have a 20% chance to deal double damage. That sounds really good. So we'll put this in the unique tab or something when we get it. She's put it up here for now. So that's her first unique item. Then maybe we'll spend our skill points here. So we have 4 skill points. What to do is go work up in this direction. And then go here, 10% reduced elemental ailment duration on you. 10% reduced effect of chill and shock on you. Then you go here, 20% reduced ignite duration on you. And then we keep going up here in this part. Because the main thing we need is this corrupted blood cannot be inflicted on you, which will make you immune to the Act 3 and the Act 4 bosses. And all the corrupt blood in the later stages. It's so, that thing will kill you so quick. So you have to go to the docks. Then I think you have to search for an item. So go search for this item here quick. Copper tower shield, 3 socket leg. Maybe we'll take this wolf pelt up here. It must be just over here, Ed. Maybe it's over here to the left. Oh, we found it. It's just right over here. So what you do now is go back to town. And then we're just about done the first half, right? All we have to do is go through the palace over there. Go through the palace. They're pretty much done here. So if you go over here, we get another skill point here. 1% to max elemental rest, 20% reduced effect of ailment duration, 20% reduced effect of chill and shock on you. So that's going to help out. That's gonna help if we get like ignited or chilled or shocked or anything. But the main thing is to get that corrupted blood ability. So we go to the battlefront over here. Oh, there's a Veil Slayer. Yes, we might be able to find something in here. So I'd be able to find some really good corrupted armor and some Veil jobs. So every time these come up, up to a certain point, eventually they probably get start getting too dangerous though. Hey, these guys aren't doing too much damage, so that's good. So we defeat the boss already? So I guess we could hear these things. Full play, Aberabulet. And then whatever's in here. Yeah, a couple of rare items, a couple of Veil Jabs. Painted Buckler. Oh, it has a different socket on it. I am no beast of burden. So do we need this tower shield? It doesn't look like it does anything. So I guess they're not that good. I guess that works. So we cleared that area. No, we can even just go to town because the bank's right here. So just go to town because the portal's right here. And I think we got like a full inventory for doing that. Got our Veil Jabs. Go back to here, and we were literally just right up here. Maybe we'll get this shield out here. Because it was max defense, and a 3 socket leg, so it's a good thing to pick up, maybe. And I think for the bows, maybe you should be looking for like a 4 socket leg. Oh, there's a scale duplet. Oh, that's right. Oh, the copper plate. Oh, copper plate's probably better. So I have to work our way up here, and then figure out how to get inside this place. And I think we just have to go through 2 levels, but that's like the first half of this act here. Oh, we don't have the skeletons? So the breaker over here, they think we have to go down the 2 levels. Oh, here's the waypoint. Maybe we'll just go bait quick. But usually when you get to a waypoint, if your inventory is like decently full, might as well be worth to go bait. What if that would be a upgrade? It's a festival mask? So how about doesn't really do anything anymore. It's just the magic element at the moment. And this has 2 blue sockets. That would give us some cold resistance. And then our cold res. Yeah, so we need to get some fighters now. All of our both of them are maxed. So we're getting pretty close to maxing all of our resistances here. So go back to the temple. Then we'll just keep working our way through here. I think we have to find like the stairs maybe. Or maybe there is no stairs. Maybe we just have to find our way to the end. We didn't have one of our gems activated. So I think we just found some good items. Oh yeah, we do have to go down to the second level here. This here's the goddess of purity, so she's like the halfway point maybe. Was not over here. Oh, don't you have a room? This is what we're gonna have to do is go make it. If we can't, oh, we could drop the scepter there. We don't really need that. I know the waypoint should be right here pretty soon. Yeah, here's the waypoint here. So what we're gonna do is we can come here. they talked to you, then I think that we had did some of these add-ups. There we go, like, two rewards. So you choose the amulet. I think you usually want the dex one, right? Because you usually need dexterity. You should get enough strength. You should get enough it. But you're usually short on dexterity. And this gold amulet rolled pretty low on it. So we'll get this one plus the dex, because we'll probably need that. Goodbye. Then over here, there's another crafting recipe. All you have to do is enter this door, and then there's another craft recipe right here. We got the fire damage rank one. They're pretty much done like the first half of the act. Pretty much done the first half here. All we do is go to town. Then we'll just go bank. So got like all these things that are in our bank and everything. So we'll probably ID that amulet because we might need it. Oh, it doesn't even have any resistances or anything. So maybe we don't need it. And then we'll just go to the sewers. Then we'll go back here. And then complete this quest here. And then we just go get this waypoint. There's another crafting recipe right here too. We get the physical damage rank 1. Then we go to the barracks. And then here we go. So we just about unlocked the skill gems and everything. So we're just at the end of Act 3 here. So that was pretty quick, I think. Then I don't think talk to this guy does anything, right? We have to kill Pai to get a reward from him. So we reached the pretty much the next checkpoint. Usually I think after you do all this stuff and then you complete the sewers, then you get this checkpoint. And then we have the rest of the Act 3 to complete. And we do have also a loot organizer. I guess it's just like 1, 2, 3 pages pretty much. Yeah, I guess we just have 3 pages of loot to sort through. So we'll probably go through, sort through this. And then in the next video, we'll pretty much go through the rest of Act 3 here. Unlock skill jabs. And maybe move on to Act 4. So yeah, we'll probably end the video, and then we'll upload it. And then by the end of the next video, we'll figure out all this loot we have here. Yeah, we got this new boots here, right? For a ranger. So we got a new ranger boots. 4 socket leg. Then maybe over here, right? We just got this bow, level 18. So we can give this to a bow, maybe. To a ranger. Yeah, I guess that works. Then we can just go through and just see what good gear we have here. Level 28 armor. Level 28 armor. So I wonder if this should, No, I guess it should go here, right? Level 28. So I guess that's good. If we find the level 28 armor, we start to put them on that page. Here's level 23 greaves. So we put these here. We got some boots for the Templar. Where are the Templar? Oh, this has the movement speed and the resistances. Yeah, then all these armors here, these two item weapons. So I think it's mostly just going to be these rares and everything. The whites will be pretty easy to sort. And I guess level 18. Would this be better than this copper plate? It's like 118 armor. But this has 4 socket licks. 4 socket licks, which might help them more, right? Like the armor, you need it, but you also need the licks. So we'll have to figure out what we do with these things. Like the 4 licks that we don't want to get rid of right now, but they aren't really that good.